Welcome. You are logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, America, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I am Drashti and today's headlines are: In India, the country will host the G20 summit in 2022 and Pakistan terror groups are reportedly using women to honey-trap JNK youths. In America, the Trump administration, along with China, have agreed to suspend new trade tariffs, and US groups have urged Indian PM Narendra Modi to curb the rise of extremism. In Punjab, Union Minister Harsimrat Kaur Badal has flayed Pakistan Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi, and ex-PL SRE leader Ranjit Singh Brahmapura has announced a new political party. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, America and Punjab. For detailed news and businesses updates of the Indo-America community, download the Indian Times Daily app. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: PM Narendra Modi has announced that India would host the annual G20 summit in 2022, coinciding with the country's 75th anniversary of independence. Modi made the announcement at the closing ceremony of the two-day G20 summit in Argentina. Honey trapping is one of the new methods being used by Pakistan-based terror groups. Through this, women are reportedly used to woo Indian youths towards militancy and use them as human carriers for delivering arms from one place to another or acting as guides to infiltrating terrorists. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj has said strict action should be taken against bogus agents who cheat people by promising jobs abroad. She said such businesses would keep running if strict action is not taken against these agents. Sunil Arora has taken over as the 23rd Chief Election Commissioner. He stated that he has sought the cooperation of political parties and people to make elections totally free, fair and ethical. The Lok Sabha elections, which are due next year, will be conducted by the poll panel under the former bureaucrat. Home Minister Rajnath Singh has said that Pakistan can seek India's help if it cannot handle the fight against terrorism alone. He asserted there has not been any major terrorist-related incident in the country in over 4 years of Narendra Modi-led NDA government. Uttar Pradesh CM Yogi Adityanath has hit out at AIMIM chief Asaduddin Owaisi. He stated that he will now have to run away from Hyderabad just like the Nizam if the BJP comes to power in Telangana. India's first locomotive-less train, Train 18, has breached the 180 km/h speed limit during a test run. In the process, the 100 crore rupees indigenously designed train has become the country's fastest train. 34 years after the Bhopal gas tragedy, survivors continue to demand proper rehabilitation and adequate compensation besides proper medical treatment for ailments caused by the toxic leak. In the world's worst industrial disaster, over 15,000 people were killed after a methyl isocyanate leak. Greg Chappell has rigid and inflexible in his approach as a coach and did not know how to run an international team. Former Indian batsman VVS Lakshman has claimed in his book. He recently launched his autobiography 281 and Beyond. Actor Priyanka Chopra and Nick Jonas' Christian wedding ceremony on December 1 at the Umaid Bhavan Palace in Jodhpur was followed by a grand firework display. While the fans congratulated the newlyweds, several Twitter users slammed the actor for bursting firecrackers despite being the face of anti-pollution campaign around Diwali. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from America and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from America are: President Donald Trump and his Chinese counterpart Xi Jinping have agreed to halt new trade tariffs for 90 days to allow for talks. At a post-G20 summit meeting, Trump agreed not to boost tariffs on $200 billion of Chinese goods from 10% to 25% on 1 January. Religious freedom activists and several other groups in the US have urged Indian PM Narendra Modi to take all necessary measures to curb the rise of Hindutva extremism. The request was made during a briefing organized by the Indian American Muslim Council. The police have reportedly said that 5 people have been shot in a Miami neighborhood and the suspect remains at large. 4 victims were transported to Jackson Memorial Hospital, where 2 are in critical condition. President Donald Trump is likely to meet North Korean leader Kim Jong-un in January or February, and the 3 sites for their second meeting are under consideration. At some point, Trump will invite Kim to the United States. Condoling the death of George H.W. Bush, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that the former US president was passionate about the strong relations between India and the US. Bush, the 41st president, led America during the collapse of the Soviet Union. A top admiral overseeing US naval forces in the Middle East was found dead in his residence in Berry. Vice Administrator Scott Sternley was found dead, but officials have said that there was no evidence of foul play at this time. The Air Forces of India and the US will begin a 12-day joint exercise, X-Scope India 2018, to provide operational exposure and enhancing operational capability. It will be the fourth edition of the series of bilateral joint exercise held by the Air Forces of the two nations in India. The White House has said that President Donald Trump had an informal conversation with his Russian counterpart, Vladimir Putin. Trump and the First Lady had a number of informal conversations with world leaders, including Putin at the dinner in Buenos Aires. President Donald Trump and German Chancellor Angela Merkel exchanged views on trade and security on the sidelines of G20 summit in Buenos Aires. The two leaders also exchanged thoughts on Russia's violation of the Intermediate-Range Nuclear Forces Treaty. Mexican authorities are investigating an apparent grenade attack on the US consulate in the city of Guadalajara. The attack took place early on Saturday morning ahead of the swearing-in of President Andrés Manuel López Obrador. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Union Minister Harsimran Kaur Badal slammed Pakistan Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi. He had reportedly said that Pakistan PM Imran Khan's Kartarpur Gugli has forced India to send two ministers to the groundbreaking ceremony for the Kartarpur corridor. Senior SED leader Ranjit Singh Brahmapura has announced a new political party. The move comes less than a month after the party expelled him and two other senior Akali leaders. The elections of the Chief Khalsa Diwan have been stayed till further orders. The decision came after Harjit Singh Sachdeva filed a petition in court alleging that the votes were being created in the names of people who had already died. Several ministers have condemned their colleague Navjot Singh Sidhu's jibe at CM Amrinder Singh. The ministers are also demanding that Sidhu apologize to Amrinder and learn how to respect elders. The PPCB has renominated environmentalist Balbir Singh Sijewal as its member with immediate effect. The move came on the orders of Chief Minister Amrinder Singh. Teachers have called off their 56-day-old strike after Education Minister O.P. Soni gave an assurance to review their regularization at a monthly salary of ₹15,300. CM Amrinder Singh will also meet the teachers to discuss the issue. Former SED Minister Bikram Singh Majithia has scoffed at the feud between CM Amrinder Singh and Cabinet Minister Navjot Singh Sidhu. He said that the Congress was like a football team which refused to acknowledge Lionel Messi as its captain. The Food Supply Department's vigilance team has caught six trucks transporting paddy illegally from other states. The rice and paddy was meant to be illegally sold in Punjab's mandis. Experts have laid emphasis on the viability of commercial dairy farming in Punjab through scientific management of clean milk production and marketing of milk. The statement came during first session of Kisan Goshtis at the 13th AgroTech India, being held in Chandigarh. The police have beaten Rock Rovers of Chandigarh by 5-0 to enter the semi-finals on the third day of Dashmesh Hawks All India Hockey Festival. Meanwhile, Signals of Jalandhar edged past Punjab State Power Corporation Limited of Patiala by 10-9 to reach the semis. This is the end of News Bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-American businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Ayushman Khurrana, who has been giving everyone a run for their money with his successful movies like Andhadhun and Badhai Ho, is returning to the big screen with yet another project named In It As Dream Girl. In a video recently released by Ayushman Khurrana, he can be seen sitting with a creative team who come up with movie ideas similar to the actor's films. Later, a help comes with an idea for a movie and the actor leaps with a joy at having found the right script. Holding the copy of the script, Ayushman looks into the camera and says, "So guys, this is my next film." Ayushman captioned the video, "Of every possible role, this one, I would be honest, would have never crossed my mind. But here I am to play a role in and as Dream Girl." It will also see Nishit Bharucha in lead role. Dream Girl marks the first collaboration of Ayushman Khurrana and Ekta Kapoor also. Superstar Aamir Khan is saddened knowing about the devastation Cyclone Gaja wrought on Tamil Nadu and has urged his fans and followers to contribute generously to alleviate their suffering. I'm very saddened to hear of the devastation caused by Cyclone Gaja in Tamil Nadu. Let us all come together to help our brothers and sisters there who are suffering. Let us try and contribute in any way that we can, the Bollywood actor tweeted on Friday. Tamil superstar politician Kamal Hassan, who has visited the cyclone-ravaged areas of the state, thanked him for the gesture. Thank you so much, Aamir Khanji. In many ways, people like you make us feel it's truly one country, Kamal wrote back. Cyclonic storm Gaja crossed Tamil Nadu coast on November 16, leaving over 50 people and thousands of livestock dead and damaging properties, starting crops, coconut groves, banana plantations and power distribution infrastructure in several districts. Tamil Nadu Chief Minister K. Palaniswamy met Prime Minister Narendra Modi and sought the central's assistance of Rs. 15,000 crore for 12 districts hit by the cyclone.
Kick actress Jacqueline Fernandez, known for her pole dance moves and stylish appearances, believes that finding love is a great thing. During media interaction at the launch event of a watch brand, Jacqueline shared how she feels about her contemporaries getting married this year.
Yeah, so I'm very excited. I mean, like, I think this has been such an amazing year for our film industries. I mean, everyone's, you know, I think it's such a great thing, you know, marriage and finding the love of your life, and everyone just seems so happy. Sonam got married this year, Anushka got married, Priyanka and Adipika. It's just fun times. It's a great time for everyone, I think.
She spoke about her upcoming film Drive with Sushant Singh Rajput being indefinitely postponed. She said,
Well, so far we're actually still shooting Patchwork. But yeah, we are actually focusing on making sure that the film releases early next year.
She's soon going to work with Sonu Ki Titu Ki Sweetie fame Karthik Aaryan in a film which would be a Tamil remake.
I'm excited to be able to work with Karthik, and we've also got a fantastic director on board. But we're still in the scripting process. So hopefully soon we should be able to start.
When asked if she will be coming on Karan Johar's show Coffee with Karan, she said,
No, I think maybe next time.
On the work front, Jacqueline was last seen in Salman Khan's Tara Race 3. The actress would be next seen in Drive, which stars Sushant Singh Rajput in the lead role. It will be helmed by Tarun Mansukhani and produced by Karan Johar's Dharma Productions. Ranbir Kapoor's sister and entrepreneur Ridhima Kapoor Sani was recently accused of plagiarizing a set of diamond and pearl earrings on social media. She owns a jewelry brand and had recently unveiled new festive collections online, for which she called out for copying designs from Japanese brand. Through Instagram post, the Japanese company accused of plagiarism. Responding to it, Ridhima held her own and apologized for not crediting the original designers. Her post read, Dear Insta family, we at Ridhima Kapoor Sani Jewelry do not encourage plagiarism. We are extremely sorry for not tagging the original designer for an inspirational post of diamond and pearl earrings by Mikimoto Kokishi, a legend with pearls. We respect the creativity of every designer and would not copy or disregard any of them. Thank you. Ridhima is often seen sending her own jewelry designs as a gift to her Bollywood friends and celebrities. Actor-politician Shatrughan Sinha says veteran actress Helen, who has just turned 80, was a true style diva in the 1960s and 1970s and excelled with her clean dance moves in her famous cabaret numbers. Shatrughan Sinha tweeted on Friday, loving and warm birthday wishes Helen, wife of legendary scriptwriter Salim Khan. During 1960s, 1970s, she was the most popular and loved dancer. She excelled with her graceful, elegant and clean dance moves in her famous cabaret and item numbers. She was a true style diva for her innovative wigs and fabulous costumes. Helen turned on 80 on 21st November. Shatrughan, who has worked with the actress in films like Parwana and Dostana, said that her songs Ye Mera Dil Pyar Ka Deewana, Piya Tu Ab To Aaja, Aao Na Gale Lagao Na, are humped and remain favorites even today. He added, starting out as a chorus dancer, her rise to the top was both painful and appreciable. She performed on the international stage also.